Thank you. So I think you can understand that I am pro for pot and kissing bone inflation. So what is special with bifurcation lesion? I think it's very important to have that in mind because it has many implications in the technique and the strategy. So rheology is special because you have a bifurcation, so a carina, which is a flow divider with areas of low shear stress opposite to the carina. So this is a place where atheroma is developing, so opposite to the carina. Usually there is no atheroma at the level of the carina. So no need for stents at this level. Second point, very important, is that like all everywhere in the nature, we have a fractal law of bifurcation lesion. So a very strong relationship between the proximal membrane diameter, the distal membrane diameter on the side branch, which was nicely described by Murray in the 19th century, and then adapted by Hugo Kassab, and finally simplified by Gérard Finet with this formula, so addition of the two distal branches multiplied by 2 divided by 3, it's equal the proximal membrane. So this is very important. So it explains why POT is so important. So the POT was described by Olivier Darmon in 12 years ago, and it's very simple. So coming from this fractal law, imagine that if you use a stent which is sized according to distal reference, you will not push the carina, but of course you will have a malapposition proximal which can be correct by the POT. So if you use a balloon with the distal part, the shoulder at this level, you will have a protrusion of the stent in the side branch. So you have already some scaffolding of the side branch ostium with a main branch stent. And if you go through a distal strut, you will have this appearance of the bifurcation lesion, which looks like a dedicated stent. So this is in the bench. You see deployment of the stent. You see how it's moving. And then, after deployment, you do a POT, and you can see that now you have nice apposition and even some scaffolding of the side branch ostium with the POT. So very important. Of course, what is important when you do the POT is to have the balloon at the right place. So the shoulder should be at the level of the carina. Even here, it's a little bit too much proximal. So here, it's better. And after that, of course, you will have this kind of position. Whoops. Are you moving something? Okay. So it's very important to have know your balloon. So the shoulder here is at the level of the marker. Here also, but in some balloons it's not the case. So you know, should know the balloon to know where is the shoulder in order to do the POT at the right place. This is in when you do rheology, you can see no stent, you have an optimal rheology, stent with no POT, you see a poor rheology, and stent with POT, you see that there is some protrusion of the stent in the side branch with better rheology, nearly comparable to no stent. We have some data, so this is the data from Gérard Finet showing that with the POT, you have not a lot of ellipticity before and after, it's exactly the same, but you increase the proximal vessel size, you see 3.3, you move to 4.2, so it's a big difference, and also the obstruction by the stent is decreased 34% to 26%. So clearly, it improves the hemodynamic of the patient, but also it facilitates access toward the distal strut, because you have already a stent which is more open at the level of a bifurcation. It's also very helpful in case of occlusion. So this is a nice case with a 1-1-1 bifurcation lesion. You see access toward this small branch is very difficult, so you should keep it open. It's not a very relevant side branch, but we should keep it open. And then we have done predilatation, we have stent, And you see there was some calcification despite the fact that the stent is not fully open. We have an occlusion of the side branch. So simply by doing the pot at the right place, you can relocate the carina and then move to a good result, even in the side branch. Of course, you have this tight stenosis, which was there before. So pot is a very useful technique. It's also recommended in all kind of double stent techniques. So when you look at the recommendation for DK crush, you should do a pot at the very beginning, another pot here, and the final pot. If you do a culotte, you should do a pot after stenting the main branch, you should do a pot after stenting the side branch, and then you should do a pot at the end. So pot is something that you should do every day. Now if you look at the data, clinical data, we have data from COBIS 2, so Korean registry, which is very interesting. So they compare pot versus no pot. It's not randomized, but it's a big registry, a national registry. And you see the side branch is a big one, 2.5. Now, if you look at the MACE rate, it's divided by 4. So pot, 2.9, no pot, 12%. So very important information. However, at that time, pot was used only in 1/4 of the patient. Now we have Ultimate Registry, which is more recent, presented by Bernard Chevalier this year. And you can see again, if you compare in this registry, pod versus no pod, there is a big difference with TLF divided by 2, and also less stent thrombosis, 0% compared to 1.1, and also less target vessel MI, less TLR. So POT, again, very important clinically. However, again, it was used in only 1/3 of the patients. So even in the recent data. Now, if you look at the POT with the two-stent technique, it's exactly the same. So TLF is doubled when you don't use a POT as compared to no POT. And even with the two-stent technique, POT was used in only 42% of cases. So there is a problem with POT. Now, final kissing. Final kissing, we discovered that with Yves Louvard many years ago because doing bench testing, we realized that when we open the strut, we have this kind of deformation of the main branch stent. So we realized that we should do something to correct that. At that time, POT was not existing. So we said, okay, do a kiss, and then we correct the deformation. That's why we are doing kissing in the majority of cases in my center. You can see that if you go through a distal strut, you have, again, this nice scaffolding of a side branch ostium. The role of kiss is not only to open the main branch stent strut toward the side branch, but also reposition the carina to have an optimal rheology in both branches. Reset the polygon of confluence and improve local rheology. So it's highly recommended after two stent techniques. I think everybody agree on that. And we have a lot of data. This is from a crush study by Zavik. You see, you multiply by 5 the risk of MACE if you don't do kissing bone inflation after a crush technique. This is from Eroldi, again, with a mini crush technique. Again, you see stent thrombosis multiplied by 6, restenosis multiplied by 3 for the main branch and the side branch. So final kiss with double stent technique is very important. And this is from Korean registry. You see the MACE rate is very high, 13% compared to 0.5. So two stent technique is mandatory. Now with one stent technique, it's still controversial because we have, this is Ultimaster. Again, you see 0.0 target vessel MI is decreased by 3. But after one stent technique, it's a little bit different. But I ask you, what do you prefer? This one or this one? So clearly, you see the malapposition at the level of the ostium with kissing by inflation is better, and apposition is better. Now, in Nordic 3, there was a randomized study which compare with provisional approach, kissing, no kissing. You see the outcome at 28 weeks is the same, but there was no POT, no NC balloon, no sequential inflation, and they did not try to go through the distal sense rut. So if we look now at 8 months sibranch stenosis, you see the difference. So even in this negative study, there is a difference in terms of stenosis in the sibranch. Now, if we look at the intermaster registry with one stent, there is no difference. So kissing, no kissing is the same. COBIS2, however, they found again a big difference. So males divide by two if you do a final kiss, while in COBIS1, it was negative. So it seems that by improving the technique of POT, you improve the result for the patient. So how to do a good kiss? I think it's very important. So this is data from Olivier Darmon, inventor of kiss, of POT. So you see if you do simultaneous inflation as compared to men first, then kissing balloon, there is a difference. But the best is side first, then kissing balloon inflation and deflation of both at the same time. So sequential inflation is very important. And there is many data about that. Non-compliant balloon for the side branch, which is not stented, is very important because you see you have a dog bone effect here, which may create dissection. And we found with Thomas in a prospective study that we decrease the number of stents in the side branch by using non-compliant balloon. Using long balloon is not a good idea because you make this kind of deformation, as you can see here, as compared to minimal overlap where there is no significant deformation of the stent proximally. Time is your friend. So very important to do long inflation. You see cross-sectional area of the stent, 20 seconds plus 20 seconds plus 20 seconds. It's a big difference. And in terms of recoil, you have less recoil after 40 seconds. Now, if you look at the bench again, you can see the difference if you do main vessel only, kissing through the distal strut or kissing through the proximal strut. You see, with the proximal strut, you have a neocarina, like for the tap technique. So that's why it's very important to try to go through a distal strut. Now we have data which are very interesting from Raman. So it's not recent data, but they found that you have improvement of every parameters when you do a kissing by inflation in terms of minimal stent area, which is not decreased after side branch dilatation. So kissing balloon inflation corrects the problem of side branch opening of a strut. So to summarize, the good kiss is balloon sizing according to distal and side branch reference. It should go through a distal strut. Side branch inflated first and then kissing balloon inflation. Use non-compliant, short non-compliant balloon for the side branch. And long or repeated inflations is very important, simultaneous deflation. My conclusion for all this lecture is that POT is a logical and crucial step in the treatment of bifurcation lesion. It should be used nearly always. Final kiss is highly recommended when a two-stent technique is used, but remains debated or controversial for one-stent techniques. And POT only or POT side POT can be an alternative, as it was suggested in the room, especially when you have a small side branch. Thank you very much for your attention.